गुड आफ्टरनून
डॉक्टर निशाद डैडी।
ओके वेलकम वेलकम सर वेलकम सर हाउ आर यू।
हाँ कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन फॉर अरेंजिंग सच अ नाइस प्रोग्राम।
थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू। टेक केयर ऑफ योरसेल्फ।
यस यस वी आर टेकिंग केयर एंड वी रिमेंबर ऑल ऑफ यू एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच।
वेरी नाइस टू हियर। हेलो मैम। नमस्ते नमस्ते नमस्ते।
I hope you can join now. We'll log out otherwise.
No, no, no. You can join me.
Yeah,
you will
you.
Be in law.
Thank you.
Okay. So, good afternoon, everybody. I welcome all of you. This is the first virtual meet. Actually, before we have conducted the actual alumni meet, but due to this COVID pandemic, we are unable to arrange the face-to-face meeting. So our Honorable Namda sir has been insisting that we should be always in contact with our alumni. And you know that I have a very emotional attachment with the first batch, that is foundation batch. That batch, whenever I meet our Dr. Rohan, I always become nostalgic. We are able to see behind me, there is one photo, and all the students from your 2004 batch, the photo, you can see that photograph. So with this keynote, as I am the president, now I am very happy to share that the vice president is also from your batch, and he is Dr. Rohan Karde, and he is working very nicely in the Department of the Oncology. And he has, with the Dr. Bhushan, his department is giving a very humanitarian service to the Nagar district. So I welcome all of you again. Today, there will be three presentations. First presentation is of Dr. Nisha Kali. She is doing. She is now in a final year and doing MCH. Second, your topper, Dr. Pratik Jain. He is also doing fellowship at Tata Memorial Hospital, Kolkata. And third is of Dr. Rohan Karde, and he is giving service to our hospital. After this, I'll request our respected Dr. Sunil Nazam sir to say or guide the alumni as well as our student. Thank you, sir.
Welcome to all. Good afternoon. On behalf of Dr. Vitthal Rao Vikhe Patil Foundation's Medical College, Ahmednagar, I, Dr. Sunil Maske, as a dean, welcome you all. And this is the first web conference particular to the alumni. Because of this COVID pandemic, we have arranged it. Very grateful to see our pioneer batch, that is the foundation batch, Pratik, Rohan, and Nisha. And we are proud with their achievements. They are doing very good in their respective places. And of course, they are the brand ambassador of our medical college and institute. I wish all the best for these three ex-students, along with all the our alumni batch. I am very thankful to our alumni in charge, Dr. Sandeep Padu, who has arranged this web conference in very short notice. I thank all the members and best wishes to all for this further program. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your valuable guidance. Now I request Dr. Nisha Kali for her presentation. Nisha, over to you.
Thank you.
Nisha, you are not audible. I think range problem is there.
Hello.
Yes, but some interruption is there. I think net problem is there. Yes, yes. We can see your screen.
Okay.
Yeah.
Please,
okay. Thank you. Please
proceed. Good afternoon, everyone. I'll start my presentation. I hope you all are doing fine. All of us today are dealing with COVID in our everyday life. Give us the strength to deal with it and its atrocities. It's been over a year and our country faces. One of the bigger battles is also cancer, especially the head and neck, which our country has been a continuous of. I'm doing my MCH in headache and I've been dealing with quite a lot of cancer patients in the last few years. And I'm here to discuss with you all cancer scenario. What problems during COVID was that quarantine was well defined initially for a COVID patient before getting taken up for any procedure. Second is unavailability of resources. There were a lot of hospitals who were not operating, of institutes not giving radiation for a long time. Then a lot of patients had an effect of the lockdown. And the fourth and the most important factor is the fear factor. The factor which the fear of COVID as well as of cancer. Pertaining to head and neck is an oral generating anesthesia. So these were the problems that we all faced during the COVID period. The problems of quarantine norm that were not initially defined. This is the story in which he required hospital treatment and quarantine as per the protocol. Initially, when we had the patient had just a T2 lesion, which is a small and requiring only one modality in hospital. When he was being treated, after being tested negative, his disease had reached from stage 2 to stage 4. We can see that the skin had been involved, the temporalis muscle had been taken for surgery, followed by so we could with his mind.
Hello, Nisha. You are not audible. Hello. Hello, can you hear me, Nisha? You are not audible.
Sir, I'm not able to share my screen suddenly.
Okay. We'll make you again. Some net problem is there.
I'm unable to share my screen.
Yeah. We're again making you host. Wait for 2 minutes.
Okay, sir.
Yes, I'll try.
I'll try, sir.
Yes. Your screen is visible. Please proceed.
Okay. So this is the story of a 41-year-old gentleman who had just again a T2 lesion of the buccal cavity. And he was never offered surgery. He was only asked for rape. 41-year-old man. He didn't have a family. He just had a sister. The matters, he has severe mucositis and a large orocutaneous fistula. When he came to us, he could not eat well. All the food was coming out of the fistula. This is something which was totally inappropriate for him. To operate on this patient was a real nightmare. First of all, we wouldn't get a negative margin for him to do such a huge resection, and more importantly, the reconstruction. It was a real nightmare. Some of these patients, the most appropriate period for a cancer patient to be treated from the surgery to the end of radiation, 100-day period. Most of these patient treatment in the 100 days because of unavailability of resources, loss of access to. He had an anterior alveolar tumor in which was like growing all over the lockdown period. He went from hospital to hospital but was refused treatment. During the COVID time when he came to us, he had severe cachexia and this extensive disease, again requiring a huge resection and anterior mandible reconstruction with a bone flap. Coming to the operative cases, our OT was never shut. We had shortage of OT from 4 OTs. We were given only 2 OTs. However, in the month of April, we can see there was a severe fall in the number of cases operated. This was the actual lockdown period when our cases came down by 40 to 60%. Also, there was another fall in the month of September when actually Kerala witnessed a high number of COVID cases. So we can see almost a 40 to 60% drop during those months. However, we never stopped operating during the COVID times. Coming to the follow-up since COVID, I was doing a study for my thesis of 77 patients. 42% patients had been lost to follow-up before the year 2019, but we can see only 22% patients out of the remaining 58 had actually come to us in the end of 2020 and 2021, that is now. 36% patients decided that follow-up was not required or they were just too scared to come. This is a wrong notion because for cancer, follow-up is very important. So most of these patients during the COVID time, probably when they thought that follow-up probably is not important and they have just considered that. Also, follow-up patients difficult, this old lady extensive resection. This 5-year-old child, the lockdown was started for 2.5 months. This child could not return to her home because of lockdown. This is not the story of an old man. It is not the story of a man who was financially unstable. This is not a patient who is illiterate. This is not the story of a man who does not understand the importance of treatment. This is the story of a man who had, we can see this man when his relatives finally brought him to us. He had a, more than half the mandible involved in disease. The entire lip was involved in disease as well as a lot of skin. He had to be reconstructed with two flaps, one for the bone, that is the scapular flap, and we can see one more flap, that is the radial forearm flap for the lip. Solutions to these problems, first of all, in our department, we thought safety of self was first, and which is actually the most important, gears only when indicated. We did not ask for any antigen tests and anything for any aerosol generating procedure except when patient was being taken up in the operation theater. We took our own precautions. We made cancer treatment a priority. In our institute, cancer was treated as a hemi-emergency procedure, and the triage was made that way. We treated cancer patients as emergency patients, not that they have to be ready for us. They are admitted in an appropriate infectious disease department, which scrutinizes every patient before being taken in the operation theater. We had a triage of emergency patients. Certain patients we took without even getting the COVID report, in which there was an emergency, like a carotid blowout and an oral bleed, or all those kind of patients. We used our resources appropriately. We reserved gene expert and all these emergency test procedures for die-hard emergencies. So some good things about our department that we operated. This is the fluid on him, and we can see this being reconstructed quite well. Whose mouth was full of cancer initially when he came to us after the lockdown for treatment, the chemotherapy. This is a third patient who had a lot of effects of radiation and the huge fistula that we can see. We operated on this patient. We did operate on this patient, and this is the post-operative picture. Lot of other complications, like still out of control. This patient coming, however, COVID is not the only battle we need to win. Or your hospital cannot accommodate these patients to a higher center. Do not delay. Follow-up in a cancer is emphasized. COVID vaccination is safe in cancer patients. No cancer work.
Hello, Misha.
Yes, sir. You all were able to hear me?
Yeah, but now again, we cannot see your screen. And there is a time limit also. There is some internet problem. But
I don't know what internet, because I always use this only. But whatever the session was so knowledgeable,
we also got the severity that due to the lockdown, how many patients have been suffered, and their stage has been increased from second to third, but with your team and then you have given a very nice treatment and Saul started to save their life. Thank you very much, Nisha. All the best for your future. Now I am requesting.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yes, please remain logging. I am now requesting Dr. Pratik Jain. He is now doing fellowship in oncology department at Tata Memorial Hospital, Kolkata. And you know he was the topper of 2004 batch. Now Pratik, over to you.
Well, thank you, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak to my fellow colleagues and the current batch of the VPMC. Can I request Rohan to share the presentation? Rohan?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Just... Just Nisha is being host, so we are trying to get it back.
Dr. Pratik, meanwhile, can you please share your experience? Can you just please share your experience till we start the screen?
Okay, no issues. So, I'll be talking about cancer screening, the condition in India, and the scope. I would like to thank Zamre ma'am, who have been very active in teaching us all this PSM, and we were sitting on those benches. That's where we got interested in PSM and biostats and all these screening techniques and everything. So I've kept it very basic so that the undergraduate students who are with us can actually see this, understand why it's important to screen the cancers so that when they progress in their life and get onto the other side of the bench, they would be able to understand the issues and sort it out and help their patients well. So sir has nicely introduced me already. I am working as a junior consultant in Tata Medical Center in Kolkata. Next slide, please. Yeah, so Indian scenario, what has happened in India so far? In India, over 60% of the patients present in advanced stages of cancer. Reasons can be many, their ignorance towards their symptoms, lack of healthcare facilities available, lack of money, social issues. So there is an average primary delay of 3 months. That is from the day patient identifies his first symptom till he reaches an appropriate center where he needs treatment. Next slide. And that's where screening becomes very important in India. So what is screening? Screening is an attempt to detect cancer early by routine examination of apparently healthy people. This will help us to identify cancer at an early stage or even before cancer has developed with precancerous lesions. So basically, screening aims to detect the cancer at a stage where the symptoms are still to manifest. There are two types. One is universal screening and the other is selective screening. Universal screening is where you screen entire population for a particular lesion or particular disease. Whereas selective screening is you select out a small section of the population whom you think that the risk of having the malignancy is more, and you screen those people. What prerequisites should a screening test have? It should be inexpensive because you are applying it to a larger sect of people, so it should not cost you much. It should preferably be non-invasive, quickly done, and non-hazardous to the patient, and it should have high sensitivity. So what is sensitivity? It should be able to detect as many positives as it could. India has many cancer screening programs in place even now, but nothing has shown good results as cervical cancer screening. where the mainstay of screening remains pap smear. It is recommended that you start it at the age of 25 to 30 years, and every lady should have screening once in 3 years. This is one of the most robust screening programs across the world, including India, and has shown remarkable efficacy in reducing the identification of cervical cancers at an advanced stage. Second organ where cancer screening has been effective is breast cancer. If you go on YouTube and put self-breast exams, you will have plenty of videos which will show you how to actually examine every woman can do it on her own. Apart from that, there are some other tests like mammography, it's a ultrasound and an X-ray of the breast, which will identify lesions which are not easily palpable. Thermography, tissue sampling, which will tell us the exact nature of the lesion, and of course MRI. But MRI becomes an expensive tool. But with clinical self-breast examination and mammography, most of the breast cancer patients can be identified at an early age. And it is recommended that we start at the age of 35 years for all the females. Next slide. Colorectal cancers, they are not, the screening is not so common in India, but if somebody has a history of colorectal cancers in their family, then they can go for this, where you can do fecal occult blood testing, sigmoidoscopy or colonoscopy. And if started at an appropriate age, we can almost identify all colorectal cancers, because most of them will originate in benign polyps, which can be identified and nipped in the bud. So the recommendation is that it should begin at the age of 50 years and should continue till 75. After 75, they don't recommend it, because then the life expectancy is 10 years and the benefits outweigh the expenses. In oral cancers, the screening has not become very successful, because only 5% of the malignancies show progression from pre-malignant lesions. And that's why the screening has not become a valuable tool. But still, what we can do is we can do oral examination. There are some techniques of vital staining, cytology, and light-based techniques like narrowband imaging and all, which can help to identify oral cancers and pre-malignant lesions at an early stage. Next slide. So as I earlier said, there are two types of screening. One is universal screening and the other is selective screening. So a type of selective screening is high-risk group screenings, which is important because we stay in India, which is a very resource-constrained country. And considering the current situation of pandemic, which is going to stay over here for some days to come, it exposes lesser people to healthcare and to a possible infection. So in oral cancer, if we do a population-based screening, we are expecting to avoid one death when we screen 2,043 patients. Whereas if you screen only high-risk patients, like those who have been exposed to tobacco in smoked or smokeless form or alcohol, this number can be reduced to one death prevented in 1,060 patients. Whereas in breast cancer, population-based screening, we can identify 11.5 cancers in 1,000 mammograms. Whereas high-risk group screening, like patients who are nulliparous, who have not breastfed, or those who have a family history, we can identify more than 36 cancers in 1,000 mammograms. Uh-huh. You can see high-risk screening can help in identification of more patients at lesser cost. Next slide.
Pratik.
Yes, sir.
5 minutes are remaining. If you...
Yes, sir. Can we go to next slide? We are almost...
We'll again log in.
Yes, sir.
If you require more time, 5 minutes are only remaining. If you require more time...
So just 2 minutes. Two minutes would be required. We are almost done. Can we have the next slide? So, as I said, why should we screen? Next slide. if you can identify oral cancers at this stage where they are T1, you will not, next slide, you will not have to treat them in this stage when they require a lot of resources, like detailed excisions and plastic surgical requirements, radiation, and all those things, all those modalities come into picture. Like Nisha said, delay causes issues. So if you could screen them at an early stage, this is the disease progression would be avoided, and we will be able to treat them at an early stage, and we'll be providing better cosmetic, functional, and therapeutic outcomes. Next slide. Again, to emphasize my point, and this is my last slide, see, our localized cancer treatment, the success rates are comparable to USA, 74% versus 81%. But if there is a regional spread in Mumbai, the success rate comes down to 20%, while it's in USA, it's 46%. So this again emphasizes the importance of screening. Next slide. So if you have any questions, you can ask if you have time. Thank you so much. I would like to thank Maske sir, Dr. Sandeep sir, and Rohan for giving me this opportunity to talk to you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Pradeep. Very elaborative, and you have given the importance of the prevention. If the screening is done at a proper time, then the further progression of disease can be restricted. Thank you very much. Now, I will request our Dr. Rohan Kharde to present his topic. Dr. Rohan Kharde is working in our hospital only, and we have the super specialty department, that is the oncology department,